Hello everybody, welcome back, Scratch for Fun here, and today we are back in Java in our tower defense game. You wanted more, so I am making more. Now, the reason I am showing you my toolbar and stuff like that today is because the reason for the bad quality today basically is because when I hit full screen on our game, it basically goes full screen, and you know, it is hard for you to see if I do some layout stuff, and basically if I'm doing layout stuff on the entire screen and just recording a tiny bit of it, because today we're going to do layout. So first of all, let's move this one into all of these so that we are not filling after doing stuff. And today, yes, as I told you, we will do some drawing and stuff like that. First of all, if scene is equal to 1, which basically means that we are in the game, we will draw a grid. Now, let's first take a look here. Let's do g.draw rectangle. This will be a rectangle at position 0, y0, width, let's do 100, and height 100. I did that wrong. There we go. Now, if I run the game right now, we'll get a green rectangle. No. Yes, when I hit space, we'll get a green rectangle up here, which we do not want. We want a gray rectangle, my bad. Color.gray. There we go. Let's open up the game again, and when we start, you can see this gray rectangle. Now, the thing is, we want our grid to be rectangled, something like that. Now, these are a little bit too big, so I think if we divide them into 50-50. And now, let's do a array. No, sorry, not array. A for loop, a double for loop. This will be integer x is equal to 0, sorry my voice there, and x, as long as x is less than 10, then we'll do x plus plus, okay? Then we will do another for loop, int y is equal to 0, oh, 0, y is less than 10, and y plus plus. Now, we want to draw the rectangle at 50, 50, and then plus, in parentheses, we do x multiplied by 50, and then here as well, plus only with y multiplied by 50, and the width and height will be 50 as always. Now, what are we doing now? We are having a double for loop. This will loop, the first loop here will say okay, loop through this 10 times, and this will also say 10 times, and this will be looped through 100 times. So, 100 times it is. Now, it will basically draw at standard position of 50, 50x and 50y, and when and this will loop through once, and this will basically start once, and then loop through this 10 times, then x will go up with 1, and then loop through 10 times. So, it will draw downwards, 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 rectangles. So if we hit space, you can see this grid here, 10 by 10 grid. Now, how big do we want our map? I think we would like our map out to here somewhere. Is that a nice spot? Looks like 25. So we can actually just change the x is less than 10 to x is less than 25, then hit the game again, and when I hit spacebar, you can see it goes out a little bit. So we want it right around here, and this is 22, I believe. 25 minus 3 is 22. So yeah, it will now go 22 out on the x. Let's change this to 20 so we can, you know, change it later again. And that is far too much. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So I think 14, or this is 15 right here. I think 15 is a nice number. So 15 here. And the way I'm doing this is basically start a game again and again and again and again. You don't need to do this because I'm basically doing this for you. Okay, so one less. Exit out of the game, 14. And you know, this is how I do at least when doing stuff like this, basically. So we got our we got position for some down here. I believe towers will be, and up here we will get we'll have our upgrades and stuff like that. This will be the main grid, basically. Now, as you can see, this is basically some width here. This is 22 multiplied by 50 in the width. Let's open up a calculator. 22 multiplied by 50, which is 1100. I get a screen width of 1400. So yeah, we got 300 extra space. Now, the thing here to note is that we will never... this will always be the same width, basically. That is the thing to remember here. We will always have the same width. Now, the width will basically be simple enough. 22... no. Let's see here. Let's go get a, grab up the calculator again. This is my screen width, and I believe this is my screen width. I'm not sure, actually. Yes, I am. Recording, hopefully. But yeah, my screen width is... let's actually just test that. System.out.println. Pretty quick. This.frame. .get width. There we go. Let's hit run. 50. Run. Okay, so my screen width is 40 more. Okay, so where are we at? Calculator. Let's just do 1440, and if we divide this by 11,000, there we go. I think that was the thing here. We'll get a number, and basically this number is how big I believe our screen is. Or you know, you can always always take how to say this. Okay, so I got it now. Basically the width of our exposition, or the width of our rectangle, will basically be the this dot frame, there we go, dot get width. Then we need to divide this by in parentheses 14,000 divided by 11,000, like having it in parentheses, but you know, and then we divide the entire thingy here. Let's do this again, and we divide the entire thing here on 22. Okay, so what we get on, we get by doing this, we get 50. Okay, let's test this out. We first of all get the width and divide that by okay, so let's do this. 140 divided by 1100 is basically a number like that. And then if we divide 14,000 divided by that number, which was something like 13, something like this, I think it was at least, and hit enter, and then divide. Yes, and now we basically got how much space we want to use on the entire thingy. Then by dividing that by 22, which is the amount of routes we get 50, or approximately 50. So yeah, that is pretty neat. And by doing this math, we will get the same amount of routes on the X position, so 198x. We will get some weird routes, or squares, or rectangles. What is up with this? I am not sure. It will basically get with 's something weird here. That's the system.out.println. Let's print out the X position. No, sorry, the width of every single square. Let's try this again. And let's exit out now that we've gathered some data. Oh, 65. Interesting. What we actually need to do, I believe, is make a double and call this width. Okay, and this width double will be equal to this value right here. And then the width will be in here instead. What just happened there? Width in here. So, what we're basically doing now, let's print out width, is we are, let's cast this to an integer. Our width right here is basically doing this as a integer. It's basically a integer can't have a comma, basically. So it's basically rounding out every single number, which, you know, isn't that great for us. So let's try this again. Oh, it's still looking weird. 65.0. Let's make another double here. Let's make a double called with 1. Set this one equal to this value right here. And do divided by with 1. Will that help us any at all? It should help us. Doesn't look like it did. We now get another number, which is hopefully good. Let's make it double with 2. Set this one equal to this one right here. And let's just take that out. And we got our width 2 divided by 22, which should be pretty darn accurate. Hopefully. Nope, it isn't. I'm not sure why this isn't working.
Right now, we got, I've been doing some testing here, printing out all of the variables so when we run the game, it's based, the game starts up, and we close down the game. The first variable we see here is width, which is the end size, and then we got the the width 1 here, which is 1.0. Now this should be 1.3. But we do not get that. I've tried, we only get 1.0. Not sure how to do this, but you know, I wouldn't say this would be 1. Or this is not 1. Now I've been trying here as well. It says, you know, it's 1. And yeah, this is just weird at the moment. Not sure what's happening, but I don't like it. Okay, so I've done a little bit more testing. I added 4 zeros to this thing right here, and then I divide it later. And it looks like we do get the right number. But, you know, I think this is a little bit weird way to do it, and then we get a number like this, which is the number 3 here, and number 2, no, this should be number 3 divided by 22 actually, So yeah. But one problem is we don't get the top ones. So we do get this one. Print out the width. Okay, so the width is not that much actually. Oh yes, that's because we are actually using this one right here, which is not what we want to use. We want to use width 2 right here. So yeah, if you don't get it, just please update to this. I'll be doing some in the background. So yeah, now we get this right here. And I believe if our screen is shorter, this would still work. So let's add some more thing is only change width to height. So hold over, hit Control F, and then type in width and height, replace all. And there you go. You got your variables, get height, capital H, and there we go. Now we do not need these anymore. And here we need to update this number right here. My screen height is something like this. Just update to these numbers you as well, because then you hopefully at least will get the same amount of screen as me, kind of. You know what I'm trying to do is basically get it doesn't matter the size of your screen, you'll always have the same amount of area, kind of. So I think that is the right number right there, and we got divided by that is not the correct number. We will have to print out system.out.println. We need to print out this.frame.getHeight. No, we know our height is 900. We don't need to print out anything actually. We know, just need a calculator. We know that my height is 900, and we know that y is 14, so 14 multiplied with 50, 700, so we'll need to change this to 700, and yeah, I think that is it, and change 22 to 14, and here I think cast int to height, I think should do the trick. And yeah, let's give it a go. Let's hit start. And there we go, beautiful. So these might not be squares for everyone. It's, you know, it's all about your screen size and stuff like that. Sorry about that. Just hit the microphone there. But yeah, I think next time we will do some more stuff to this thingy. We didn't do too much this episode, but hopefully we'll get in the thingy right here, and we will start creating some towels and some graphics for our game. And that will be swell. So yeah, let's try to figure out where it says our screen size here, our screen width. Here we go. So yeah. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. I am ScratchFun, and I will see you all guys next time. Goodbye. Have a nice day.